whose FC value is less than 1, so it would be downregulated gene. So we will simply go here and we will write the formula using. Welcome to another video tutorial. In this video, I will tell you how we can analyze our RNA-seq data and calculate FC value, log 2 FC value, P calculated value, then P adjusted value, and then we will find up and down regulated gene, and finally we will find significant and non-significant genes using only this simple Excel program. So as we know that whenever we send our samples to the company, the company usually send us all the RNA-seq data in the form of gene IDs and in the form of base reads. Like here you can see I have 3 replicates of wild type, and we know that usually the wild types are controlled. And here is my mutant type. You can see here I have 3 replicates of mutant type which are considered as treatment. So now I will show you that how we can calculate FC value and log up to FC value and later on all these parameters. But before that, we should take an average of all these base mean reads or FPKM values reads. So for this, you can insert one column before this wild type and mutant type both, and we can insert entire column. And similarly, we can also insert one column after mutant type. So you can see here now the column is inserted. So now we will take the average of control and treatment. So here we can write the average. Then we know that this is the average of wild type. And similarly, this would be the average of mutant type. So we will write average, and we will double click on this average, and we will just simply select these 3 values for which we need to calculate the average. And here you can see the average is calculated. You can simply double click on this dot, so it will automatically calculate the average of all. So for the wild type, we can highlight with any color like this one, and similarly now we will calculate the average of mutant type. So we can go with formula again, and we will write average. You can see here now the average formula is visible. We will select these 3 values and we will close the bracket and press enter, and similarly we will double click on this dot, so it will automatically calculate average values of mutant type. So similarly, we can highlight them with like little green color. So now our first task in RNA-seq data is that we need to know that how much fold this value is different than its control. For simplicity, we can just simply consider this. We can do this by formula. So we need to divide this mutant type value with the control value. So we know that the value of this cell should be divided by this cell. So we can simply write the address of this cell. It should be divided by the value of that control cell. So it will calculate the FC value. So it shows that because this value is less than 1, so it means that this value is slightly less than this. So we can double click on this, so it will show us the FC value of all. So here we can see here this value is greater than 1. It means this gene is little upregulated in the mutant type. And we can see here this gene is 81 times upregulated in the mutant type. And here you can see this gene is only 0.2. It means this gene is downregulated. So now we need to calculate the log 2 FC value. So we will simply do this by formula. So we will start with the formula with equal sign, and we will write log. We can double click on this, And first we need to select that FC value we have just got. And now we need to select the base because we are using our base value of 2. So we will write here as 2. So now it will calculate the log 2 FC value. Here you can see here are all the log 2 FC values of our gene data. So our the next step is we need to calculate the probability. So we need to apply the t-test. So we can start with equal sign and go with t-test. We can double click on this and you can see here the first one we should select the array 1. So here is array 1 of the wild type. And here is the mutant type. And now we need to select the one tail test or two tail test if because we are using one tail test. So we can go with 1-1. And because now we are using mean, so we will simply use this paired sample mean test. So we can simply close the bracket and we'll click on here. So here you can see we have now all the p calculated values for all this. So now we need to first find the p adjusted value of all these. Although there are many ways to calculate the p adjusted values, but here I will show you a simple way to calculate the p adjusted values of all this. So you can simply just copy all these values for which you need to calculate the p adjusted value. And you can simply open the Google and you can write Benjamini FDR correction online. So here is the first link. You can simply click on this one. So here you can just paste all the values which you have copied from this Excel sheet. I have just simply copied these values and pasted here. And now you can calculate here and it will automatically correct the probabilities and remove error. And we can go back to our that Excel sheet and we can paste those values here. We can go here and we can paste special and we can paste them as text. So you can see here now our that values are pasted here, but here you can see all the values are in one cell. So we need to first convert them and need to change them in the form of column. So for this we can go to data tab and we can change the text to the column because here all the values are separated with comma. So we need to delimit them with the help of this comma. So here we can paste one comma. So you can see by pasting the comma all the values are separated and we can just simply finish. So now here you can see the all values are separated using this comma. So now we will copy this and we can go back here and paste our adjusted values here. Because this value is in the form of row, so we need to paste it in the form of column. So we will go here. We will go to paste special and we will use transpose options. So here you can see our values are pasted. So we can go here and we can delete them. So far now we have p adjusted values and now we need to select that which genes are upregulated and which genes are downregulated. We know that usually any gene whose FC value is greater than 1 is actually the upregulated gene. And if any gene whose FC value is less than 1, so it would be downregulated gene. So we will simply go here and we will write the formula using if. So we can write the if formula. You can see here is the FC value. And we will click on this FC address. We can see this address is K3. So if K3 is greater than 1, so it will be up. Otherwise, it will be down regulated. So we will simply use this formula. So you can see here this gene is actually downregulated because the FC value is greater less than. You can see this gene is downregulated because the FC value is 0.9. So we will simply drag this corner, and you can see now we have up and down regulated genes separately. So in the last step, we need to know that which genes are significant and which genes are non-significant. And we know that in order to filter those genes which are significant, we have to see the P adjusted value. So if we know that if the P adjusted value is less than 0.05, then that gene would be significant. So you can see here we have the P adjusted cell. So we will use this column in order to filter our genes for significance or non-significance. So we will use if function, and we will write if. Here we can write the if address of this P adjusted value. So, and we will click on this, that if N3 is less than 0.05, so it would be significant. Otherwise, it would be non-significant. We will simply close the bracket and click enter. Here you can see this gene is down-regulated, but this gene is non-significant, so we need to ignore this. And simply we can drag on this corner, so it will show us our significant genes. And here you can see we have now 4 significant genes. Among them, this is upregulated, this is downregulated, and this is also upregulated. So in order to further know that which is at the top, so now we will consider at a time this significance and this FC value, or this log 2 FC value. So while considering significance and log 2 FC value, you can see here this gene is significantly upregulated and its log FC value is highest, that is 6.3. And if we go here, you can see this gene is down regulated and its log 2 FC value is highest in minus. So it means this gene is most down regulated and this gene is most up regulated. So in this way, you can also analyze and find your significant and non-significant. Meanwhile, you can also find your up and down regulated genes using simple Excel functions. So if you have still any other question, please let me know in the comment section. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.